Delta Sly Honey by Lucius Shepherd.
Delta Sly Honey, do you read? Do you read? Over.
That was this guy I knew in the NAM at the big army camp at Knock Lynn. Worked the corpse detail. Randall J. Willingham. Skinny southern boy with a plague of freckles and eyes blue as poker chips. Shy kid. You wouldn't get much of a word out of him, except sometimes when he got high. And he'd wander up to the operations bunk and start spouting all kinds of shit over the radio, just broadcasting live to whoever was out there listening. Only instead of using ordinary unit call signs, he'd invent others that suited the country lyricism of his style. Names such as Lobo Angel Silver or
Delta Sly Honey, do you read? Over. I know you're out there, Delta Sly Honey. I can see you clear, walking the high country near Black Virgin Mountain, moving through twists of fog like battle smoke, and feeling a little afraid. 'Cause though you've gone from the world, there's a world of fear between here and the hereafter. Come back at me, Delta Sly Honey. Tell me how it's going.
Funny thing is, except when he had a mic in his hand, you could hardly get a word out of Randall. A lot of guys reckon Randall didn't get higher than two figures in old IQ department, but when he put his voice into the airwaves and his spirit streamed out, he was truly something else.
Do you copy, Delta Sly Honey, out there along the Thunder Road and the Napalm Coast? This is Randall J., and I am the high priest of the soulful truth. And the Holy Ghost of the 60-cycle hum.
I was part of the military police contingent at Knock Lynn, and I guess the closest thing Randall had to a friend. We weren't really tight, but I was from the South myself, and I was still familiar with farm boys like Randall. Fey. Quiet. With vulnerabilities that ran deep. Closest thing Randall had for an enemy, and it was pretty damn close, was Top Sergeant Andrew Moon, an army lifer who chose Randall as his whipping boy. Don't ask me why.
Do you have a problem, Willingham? Do you find it mortifying to hump the mortal remains of men who did their duty fighting the enemy instead of sneaking out of active service back at base camp?
No.
No, Sergeant!
No, Sergeant!
No, Sergeant! What, Sergeant?
What, Sergeant?
Is that how they breed them where you come from, Willingham?
Sir?
Sergeant! Listen, I don't like you, boy. I don't like you one little bit. You are an insult to this army. The very sight of you makes me feel like someone took a dump on my nice, shiny barracks floor. Now you get your hands off your pecker, and you stop thinking about your sister, and do some work! Soldier!
Yes, sir?
Snap into it!
Most mornings, I'd stop by the shed where Randall slid the corpses into body bags and stacked them like huge black fruit.
Morning, Randall.
Sir!
It's okay. Relax.
Sir?
How's it going?
Well, I guess, like you see, sir, it's gone.
And, Sergeant Moon?
Sir?
I mean, he's not...
Sir?
Yeah, well... Just, carry on.
Yes, sir.
I guess I'd hope maybe to turn some of Moon's meanness off of Randall and onto myself. Figuring I could handle it better. At least I wasn't looking at stomach cavities and faces blown off for most of my working day.
Lieutenant.
Morning, Sergeant. I just wanted a word.
Sir.
About, Randall Willingham.
Sir.
I don't like the way you treat that man.
Sir?
You know what I mean, Sergeant. You come down on him, you bully him.
Is that your opinion, sir?
It's my opinion that men like you, Sergeant, get a little power and can't resist using it because...
Oh, go on, sir.
Because there's a meanness inside you that just has to slop over onto somebody else.
And the officer reckons he could handle it better than Randall J. You know, I couldn't figure out why you were butting up to that fool, so I had a look at your records. Yeah, now I got it.
And exactly what did you get, Sergeant?
Oh, you got quite a heritage, son. All that noble Southern blood, all them dead generals and senators. When I seen that, I said to myself, now don't you go get on this boy's case too heavy, Andy. He's just trying to be like his great-granddaddy, doing a kindness now and then to them dockies and the poor white trash. Ain't that right?
My motives aren't in question here.
Well, neither are mine, at least not by anybody who counts. You got some nice duty here in the camp, son. But you go screwing with me, I'm going to have your ass walking point in country before you can blink. And you know I can do it, don't you? Now, you just get out of here.
Sergeant Moon.
Come around the shed any time, son. I ain't got nothing against noblesse oblige. Fact is, I love to watch.
Oh, he could do it all right. Any man who's made top sergeant has also made powerful friends. So I walked away, knowing that now Randall was lost. Moon would be down on him harder than hell. A couple of nights after my talk with the sergeant, I was on duty in the operations bunker when Randall did his broadcast.
Delta Sly, honey. Maybe you don't think I'd understand your troubles, brothers. I truly do. I know your hopes. I'm tracking you as you move higher and higher towards the peace at the end of everything. With angels like tracers are leading you on. Listening to the cold, white song of incoming stars. Come back at me, Delta Sly, honey. This here's your good buddy, Randall J. Earthbound at Knot Lynn. Do you read?
Don't you ever get tired of that, Randall?
Well, no, sir. I guess I don't. Just keep waiting for them old boys to...
Randall J. Randall J.
What the...
Hey, looks like somebody got your number, Randall.
No, what's your position, Delta Sly, honey?
Knock it off, Randall. Just some grunt having a joke.
I repeat, what's your position?
I guess you might say our position's kind of relative. But as far as you're concerned, man, we're just down the road. There's a place for you with us, Randall J. We waiting for you.
Oh, no,
You know how it is when you're pinned down by fire, lying flat with the flow of bullets passing inches over your head. And you start thinking how easy it'd be just to rise up and get it over with. You ever feel like that, Randall J? Most times you keep flat, because things ain't bad enough to make you go that route. But the way things been going for you, man, what with sticking your hands into dead meat night and day...
Shut up. Stop it.
Son of a bitch, Moon, messing with your mind. Maybe it's time to consider your options.
Shut up. Shut up.
Take it easy. It's just some jerk off putting you on.
No.
I ain't trying to mess with you, man. I'm just laying it out, showing you there ain't no real options here. I know all them crazy thoughts been flapping around your head, and I know how hard you've been trying to control them. Ain't no point in that no more, Randall J. You belong to us now. All you gotta do is take a little walk down the road, and we be waiting. Got some serious humping ahead of us, out past the Napalm Coast, up beyond my heart.
No, it's all wrong. It's all wrong.
Randall, hold on, boy.
I gotta find him. I gotta tell him it ain't my time.
It's just someone playing a goddamn joke. It's Moon, Randall. You know it's him putting someone up to it. It's his kind of mean.
No,
and...
I gotta find him. Don't you see? I have to tell him it ain't my time.
I told him it was a joke. But somehow, I knew it wasn't. Next morning, Randall was AWOL.
Sergeant Moon!
Sir.
He's gone.
Sir?
Willingham.
Does the officer require reply?
Damn it, Sergeant, you did this.
No, sir.
Then you caused it to be done. You put someone up to it.
No, sir.
I'll find out, Sergeant, and when I do...
You'll do nothing, sir. There's nothing to do.
Now, was there anything else, sir?
Looked like the Randall show was all over. No more broadcasts. Just the usual traffic of orders and dispositions, and then one night, when the ops hut was crowded with guys.
Howdy, Knock Lynn. This here's Randall J. Willingham, on patrol with Delta Sly Honey, speaking to you from beyond the Napalm Coast. We've been humping through the rain and fog most of the day. No sign of the enemy. Just a few demons twisting up from the gray and fading when we come near. You know, brothers, I used to be scared shitless of waking up here in the big nothing. But now it's gone and happened, I find it ain't so bad. At least I got the feeling I'm headed somewhere. Back in Knock Lynn, I was spinning like I was going to lose my mind. I sure hated old Sergeant Moon. I hated him worse after he put someone up to hassling me over the radio. But now I can see he was acting under the influence of a higher agency, helping me get clear of Knock Lynn. Something that had to be, you might say. Even if I had to die to do it. All that violence, I reckon it had the effect of letting a little magic seep back into the world. This is Randall J. with Delta Sly Honey. Over and out.
Lieutenant.
Yes, Sergeant.
We gotta talk.
Go on.
You know, though, there's some guys around, they didn't like Willingham or nothing. Only
they enjoyed the broadcast?
Yeah, that sort of stuff.
Those sort of guys, Sergeant. Special forces sort of guys? Who wouldn't think once, never mind twice, about cutting a man's throat? Those sort of guys?
They think. Some of them think it was me. I can make it good for you, Lieutenant. You want duty in Hawaii? I can arrange it. Hell, I can get your ship back to the world. I can do anything. Just tell them it wasn't me. I can make you rich.
If you can do all that, Top, then you ain't got a worry in the world. Dismissed, Sergeant Moon.
You can't do this. You can't. Kurtz, wait a minute.
Hey, Joe. Where you going with that gun of yours?
One night, walking back to my hooch, I came across men. Faces blackened, tiger shorts, combat knives, their eyes pointed with the reflected brilliance of the perimeter lights. They were dragging something. Someone.
You men, stop! What are you doing with Sergeant Moon?
This ain't none of your affair, Kurt.
Put him down.
Sorry, man's gotta pay for his crimes.
He didn't do anything. You know damn well Randall just went AWOL.
No, we don't know that at all.
No, it wasn't. Oh.
No matter what he did or didn't do, the man deserves what's coming.
Lieutenant, you gotta help
me. If it ain't us, it'll be someone sooner or later.
You have to let him go.
Be reasonable, Kurt. This ain't getting you nowhere.
Reasonable? You see this? Colt 12 shot. Classic weapon, yeah? Any second now, you don't let him go, I'm gonna use it.
Please.
He ain't gonna use it.
Who are you anyway? What's your unit? I don't know you, man.
Randall told us that you could. He's a buddy of ours.
We're with Delta Sly Honey.
Yeah, sure you are. Now put his ass down.
That what you want?
Yeah, that's what I want.
You got it.
He cut Moon's throat with one fluid stroke. The man looked at me. I couldn't fire. They faded into the night and rain, and I pulled out a bottle of sour mash and drank some, went to my hooch, sat cross-legged and listened to music. And tried to finish a long letter home I'd begun nearly 2 weeks before, but what could I tell them? That I'd just sanctioned an execution? that I was losing my mind. I had another drink, and another, and another. I had a weak R&R and I took it. I guess I hoped debauch would shore me up, stop me thinking. It didn't. Only when I got back to Knock Lynn, I found Randall had returned as well. He said he lost his memory, knew nothing at all from running out the hut that day to the day he came back. He was treated like a pariah. Guys would have cheered if he'd off moon by himself, but to job out the dirty work.
Sir?
I see they put you back on the corpse detail, Randall.
The shrinks figured I wanted a Section H, so here I am.
Here you are.
Something happened.
Sergeant Moon got iced, Randall.
They think it was me set it up. That what you think, sir?
I don't know what to think.
It wasn't. I can't remember. I can't remember.
Well,
a fella yesterday on the chow line. He turned himself around, just upped and hit me. Knocked me down. Other guys, they would have joined in too if they're out to get me, sir.
Look, it's okay. Sooner or later, this whole thing will blow over. Sure, it'll blow over.
No, it ain't gonna blow over. Not with these guys.
What guys?
Delta Sly Honey.
Oh, for God's sake, Randall, come on.
It's true.
You need to get out of here. All these bodies are driving you nuts. Come on, we'll get a cup of coffee or beer.
They ought to get me. They say I crossed over and they took care of Moon for me. And then I got away from them, but I can't remember, Lieutenant. I can't remember nothing.
This
I mean,
is all crazy. Let's get you sorted out. We'll talk about it later.
You're going to help me?
Sure, we'll figure out something.
My first impulse was to tell him to drop the amnesia act. But then I thought about the painted men who had scragged Boone. If they were after Randall, he was in big trouble.
They're all looking at me. All of them reckon I set up Boone. They do, but I don't remember.
Haven't you men got something else to do?
What do you want from me? What the hell do you want? I don't remember.
I thought about what the hell I was going to do for Randall. I figured I'd go and see him, talk it through, try and find some kind of truth, if there was any kind of truth left out here. The moon was almost full, and beneath it the PX shone like a silver lozenge. Though it had closed an hour before, the windows were lit. My MP instincts engaged. I looked in. Randall was backed against the counter, holding a knife to the neck of the storekeeper, fat guy, sweating. And ranged in a loose circle around him were five men in tiger stripes, their faces painted with barbaric designs.
Hold it! For God's sake, somebody help me here. Somebody
help. Just shut your mouth.
How's she going, Kurt?
You tell him to leave me be, or I swear to God, I'll kill him.
No, I'm not
messing with you tonight. Get out now, I'll take you down.
You can't hurt us, Kurt.
Don't give me that ghost shit.
Sure sounds all fired up, don't he, fellas?
Oh, he surely does.
Thing is, Kurt, even if you were right about me, I won't be scared of dying. I was dead where it counts halfway through my tour.
Don't you move, I'll do it. I'll kill her. Just leave me be.
Come on now, Randall J., let him go. We ain't after no innocent blood. We just want you to take a little walk. Cross back over.
Get out!
You're working yourself in real deep, man.
This ain't no bullshit. I will shoot.
Look here, kid. Supposing we are just plain old ordinary grunts. You gonna shoot us all? And if you do, don't you think we're the friends who take it hard?
Anyway you slice it, man, you booking yourself a silver box and air freight home.
I looked at them, and I thought, they are ghosts. Their flesh is smoke, the paint on their faces a color in my eye.
Keep back!
You're gonna shoot us.
I warned you.
Not with that, you ain't. Need to keep her greased, Kurt, otherwise she'll plane up and jam on you.
No, no, no!
Somebody help me, anyone.
Look, let me get the knife off of Randall. No point in both of them dying.
Yeah, please, please.
You can do that.
You guys wait outside.
We ain't after no innocent blood.
Just a couple of minutes, that's all.
Okay. But don't you try nothing hinky, Kurt. We be waiting, Randall. Come on.
As soon as they were gone, I kneeled by Randall. Spit flecked the clerk's lips. He looked about finished. Randall looked about frozen stiff.
Leave me be.
Give it up. Let him go and I'll help you.
Please, I never did nothing.
But if you cut him, Randall, then you're on your own. Is that how you want it?
No.
Then turn him loose.
I can't. I'm all froze. If I move, I'll slice him.
Jesus, God, save me.
How about if I take the knife? Let me ease it out of your hand, okay? Now relax. Relax. Just keep your eyes on me. Easy, 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 easy. You gotta loosen up, Randall.
He's cut me.
I can't help you, I told you. I can't help you.
Yes, you can, Randall. You ain't setting me up here. This is down to no one but you. Relax now.
I can't.
You're crazy, man. He's insane.
Just get out now, Parker. Go.
I figured with the clerk's testimony, I could make sure the shrink sent Randall for evaluation, maybe even institutionalized him. He'd be out of it.
They're waiting, Lieutenant.
If only I could get him out of it.
Okay, soldier. We're going to head for the operations bunker. Nobody will get us out of there, no matter who they say they are. But we're going to need to move fast and low. You up to it?
I don't know. I don't know.
Well, let's find out. Move! Move! Come on, Randall, move it, man! Move it!
They were everywhere, grinning madly and waving moonstruck knives. We ran and side-slipped and turned back on ourselves and finally made the ops bunker in safety. The MP on duty was a buddy and said it was okay for us to stay the rest of the night. I had this feeling if we could get through to the daylight, we'd be home, and then I figured it. We hadn't escaped them at all. They'd herded us right to where they wanted, to where they could speak to Randall.
This is Deadly Fly Honey. Do you read? Over. I know you out there. I can see you clear, sitting with the shadows of the bars upon your soul and blood on your hands. Ain't no virtuous blood, that's true, but it stains you all the same. Come back at me, Randall G. We gotta talk, you and me.
Randall let his head fall. With a finger, he traced a line in the dust.
You left the best part of yourself over here, the soulful part. And you can't go on much longer without it. Time to take that little walk for real, man. Time to get clear of what you've done and pass on to what must be. We're waiting for you. Don't make us come and get you.
I wanted to say something to Randall. To break the spell, the voice seemed to be casting over him. But I found I had nothing left to give.
Randall J., ain't nothing to be afraid of out here. Only the wind and the gray whisper of Phantom Charlie and the trail leading away from the world. There's good company, Randall J.
There's this kid from Opelika, claims to know some of your people from down that way. Why, when he talks, you can hear crazy music leaking from the Dixieland Cafe and smell the perfumed heat steaming off the young girl's breasts. Randall, we got work to do. Maybe it ain't much, just breaking trail and walking point and keeping a sharp eye out for demons. But it sure as hell beats shepherding the dead now, don't it?
You come on and take that walk, Randall G. We'll make you welcome, I promise. This is Deadly Fly Hunter, over and out.
You hear that, Lieutenant?
I guess we all heard it, Randall.
Looks like when trouble wants you, it surely will find you out.
There's nothing here we can't handle.
That what you think, sir?
I think I can maybe get you home if you just hang on.
I don't reckon so, sir.
In his eyes, then, I thought I could see all his broken parts. And when I spoke, I felt I was giving tongue to a vast consensus, one arrived at without either ballots or reasonable discourse.
Randall, if I let you go, be best you don't come back this time.
I reckon so. Kurt?
I'll see you on your way then.
We went out into the night. The sentries at the main gate passed us through without question.
You stop here, sir.
He went a few paces along the track and turned back, his face as pale as a star in the pre-dawn gray light. I wondered if he thought we were driving him off, or if he believed he was being called to a better world. In my heart, I knew which was the case.
Randall?
At last he set off again, quickly becoming a shadow, then the rumor of a shadow, then gone. I listened in after that, night after night, somehow expecting Randall to give news of Delta Sly Honey. But there was only static, sounding like the crackling of enormous flames. I felt completely vulnerable, as if some huge black presence were on the verge of swallowing me up. Then...
This here's Delta Sly Honey, do you read? This is Delta Sly Honey, now y'all come back at me now. You hear me? You come back at me. This is Delta Sly Honey.
I was so relieved by this end of silence that I went to my hooch and, armed with lies, finished my letter home.